Excited to be spending Saturday morning here with you. And as some of you know, this is my third social in a row. So hopefully you are not tired of me yet if you've been here Thursday and Friday and you're here this morning. This morning, I'm actually coming to you from Breckenridge, Colorado. My husband and I are up here for our anniversary weekend. And so hopefully my internet holds steady. So give me a little grace if every once in a while I get a little, the internet is unstable or something, but hopefully crossing fingers will be good for the next hour or so. With me this morning is Katie, one of our other fabulous facilitators. She is here. She's going to give you a little hello, and she will be helping me monitor the chat. So if you have any questions, you're not sure where we are, not sure what you're supposed to be doing, having some sort of difficulty, pop that in the chat and we'll be there. And thank you all so much for the love. That's so sweet. We love our Sonder fam. And the nice thing about doing all these socials is the fact that I actually get them done in my journal. Believe it or not, as a facilitator, sometimes we are bad about getting our own journals filled out. So doing more socials helps me get them filled out. So welcome everyone. So if this is your first social, welcome. We're going to be working on a couple pages in our September journal. If you do not have Septembers and you're starting with us new in October, absolutely fine. We love you for being here, getting that head start. You'll probably want to use maybe some scratch paper and then you'll see the Wheel of Life, but it would be easy for you to draw if you needed to, or you can just kind of come up with your own system for doing that. So today, like I said, we're going to work on that Wheel of Life and the Balance Letter. Make sure that you have your chat set to everyone so that everyone can see kind of what you're saying. And just by being here at a social, you are entered in to win our monthly self-care gift raffle. So every month they pick someone who has attended one of our socials and send them a fun gift. So the more socials, the more entries. So sign up as many as possible. Katie, can you still get my sound? So hopefully it'll come back. I haven't gotten them. Okay, so Nona Natalie says she can hear me. Okay, awesome. Sometimes if you go in through Eventbrite, sometimes the sound is kind of in and out. So I'm not sure, Crystal, if that's, hopefully it will work okay. But let's get started. So hopefully this is going to, I'm hoping things are working okay. And there is a blank page. Someone said, there's a blank Wheel of Life in page 30 of the balance emails. I thought there was one in there too. So there will be that. So this month's theme has been balance, which has been great for a lot of us thinking about how we're going to kind of balance out our lives, things that are maybe making us feel good, maybe things that are, that we're struggling with. And I think it's really important. Meha's initial daily ritual talking about balance gave people the idea, balance doesn't always mean equal, right? It doesn't mean equal amount of work, equal amount of play, or equal amount of this, equal amount of that. It's really more about what you need more of right now, you do, and what you need less of. So sometimes there's kind of that balance, right? So it can look a little bit different. So hopefully, you've been exploring that, having fun, kind of going through that as we go through this month, which has 1 week left. So I liked this little quote, life is a balance between what we can control and what we cannot. I am learning to live between effort and surrender. So this is a great thought about this idea of balance. And it also leads in nicely to October's theme. So we're getting ready to get into that October land. So today we're going to do a little warm-up balance activity. Then we're going to do our Wheel of Life balance letter, and then we will finish up. So here's what we're going to do first. So find a blank page in your journal, or you can find a scratch piece of paper. You could do this in the scratch pad section of your week. So what you're going to do is you're going to draw yourself. This does not have to be an exact replica of yourself, right? It could be your body, something that represents you, starting with your heart. So draw your heart and then jot down some things that you've done or things you've always wanted to do, like things that your heart really wants, your heart's desires, right? And then go up to your mind and jot down whether or not you've been doing these things, or maybe there's some other things that your mind wants you to do that maybe your heart isn't so into. And so kind of thinking about that. And then outside of that sketch, write down how your head and heart connect. How can you fight against that voice in your head saying no and do what your heart desires? Also think about other parts of your body, right? Are there sometimes when your legs want to go, but your brain doesn't want to go, or your heart wants to do something, but your brain doesn't, or your legs do or don't, or arms do or don't? Where do you need some balance with that? So this is my little gingerbread drawing guy. And so I kind of have in my heart, kind of my heart's desires really is traveling domestically and internationally. I want to own a home in Sweden or Norway one day, travel around the US in a camper, adventure, and new sites, right? So different things that my heart kind of wants to do. But then sometimes my brain is saying, you need to save money for retirement. You need to pay off your student loans. You need to help take care of your family. You need to do something meaningful, maybe leave a legacy project. So I'm kind of thinking about how do those, the head and the heart, kind of go together. And then I also think about like my legs. I've completed half marathons and I want to start doing more of those. Hiking the Grand Canyon, walking in Disneyland, having flexibility, my arms, hugging my friends and family, knitting. And then I kind of wrote stretch in the middle. So kind of stretching myself to maybe do some different things. So I also want to show you this. If you have not ever seen the Awkward Yeti cartoons, they are a perfect example of that struggle for balance between the head and the heart, right? So the brain is saying, we didn't get a single thing done today. And the heart's like, you say that like it's a bad thing. And then there's also the one where the heart is saying, any task can be a game, a performance, an art, or the brain says it can be work. So the heart says, which approach will energize me? Which will deplete me? And then only I control the answer to that, right? So very fun cartoon if you haven't ever seen those before. So what I'll do is I'll kind of cycle through these instructions. Again, make it your own, really thinking about what does your head sometimes tell you? Yes, Trisha, I will be kind of going back and forth between these while I play the music. So don't be afraid of not keeping up. You're good. And I'll play a couple songs. So we got plenty of time to work on this, but really think about the brain, the head, the heart, the body, like how do they interact? How do they maybe sometimes conflict with each other? How can we help to find that balance? So you can let us know in the chat, maybe some of the things that you're thinking. Again, you can draw a little stick figure if you want. You can be, I know we have some fabulous artists in here. Maybe you want to draw yourself as a glass of water. Maybe you want to draw yourself as like an animal, right? Like a dog or a cat or something, right? Kind of thinking of that. So really, like Katie is saying in the chat, this activity is really about connecting our mind, heart, and body. But first we have to kind of think about what are the things our heart wants for us? What are the things our brain, Katie's going to do a blob. Katie, you can totally do a blob. You can do a little sparkly sun, whatever you want to use to represent yourself. All right. So I'm going to be quiet. I'm going to play some music. Hopefully if it ever gets quiet, hopefully it'll come back again. Like I said, sometimes the internet is a little sketchy up here, but hopefully that'll work out okay. And then I will pop in and check and see how everyone's going. All right. So hopefully that was kind of a fun activity, kind of drawing the little representation of yourself. Like I said, maybe it was a gingerbread, maybe it was a stick figure, maybe it was a blob, maybe it was a star. And I love this self-reflection that folks are putting in the chat, right? Like kind of thinking about, used to have a negative part of my brain that told me I couldn't do it. Used to tell me that school was only digging me a huge hole I'd never get out of. Those voices in our head can really try to squish what our heart wants us to do. So you can do it, right? It's just a matter, so much of it is a matter of just acknowledging it, recognizing it, getting it down on paper. And then when you hear that voice, you can be like, voice, that is enough. Thank you so much. I'm going to keep going. You can just kind of take a back seat. And eventually that voice will get quieter and quieter, but it's hard because it can really be loud telling you, you can't do it. When I did my first half marathon, I think I only made it to about mile 9, and then it was like just not good at all, and had to get the bus and go back to the finish line, and I felt so bad. And then I really realized so much of a lot of physical activity, or really anything, is so mental and not so much physical. So I did more training. And then the next one I did, it still was really hard, but I finished it. And then I did another one and I finished it. And then I did another one and I finished it, and got a little bit better each time. So again, had to shut that brain off, because your brain sometimes will tell you things. It thinks it's helping, right? It's kind of like, you know how when you type, you're typing something and like Microsoft thinks it's being helpful by filling in the rest. And you're like, no, that's not what I want to say. Sometimes our brains are kind of like that. So sometimes it's important to kind of quiet that down. So sometimes just writing down those thoughts and maybe putting a big X through it, and then moving on, is the best thing we can do to really fulfill those heart desires, right? And again, for a lot of fun, check out the awkwardyeti.com. Lots of fun brain heart cartoons there. So now let's move into our Wheel of Life on page 14. We usually put this in the journal about every 3 months. So it's about a quarterly check-in. Every once in a while, maybe it's 4 months, or maybe it can sometimes can only be every couple of months. But I think they try to keep it at about that every 3 months. And so this is a really nice way to get a snapshot of where you are right now. Doesn't mean you have to stay here, doesn't mean it will always be like this, but again, this is just to give you kind of that snapshot, that picture, that way to recognize how things are going. So there's these 10 different areas of your life, and you're gonna rank them between 1 to 10 based on how fulfilled you feel, or perhaps this month you wanna do it based on how balanced you feel in each one of these areas. And then maybe write down one way you can increase your level of fulfillment or your level of balance for any or all of these sections. And if any of these categories don't speak to you, sometimes people are like, the spiritual, that doesn't really speak to me. Adventure doesn't necessarily speak to me. Maybe career doesn't necessarily speak to you because you've been able to, you've retired. Or perhaps you work inside the home, you know, you're a stay-at-home mom, which is to me a huge career, but maybe you want to kind of change that up, or maybe that's mixed in with family. So feel free to change any of these up as you need to. So again, like I said, you can use the theme of balance for your grounding in this as you think about how balanced you are in each area. Maybe spend a few minutes just free writing, thinking about these areas, right? Just kind of thinking about, how do I feel about my life in general? Maybe just kind of writing some of those things down, jotting some of those down. And don't, I know a lot of times this gives people a little bit of anxiety, right? It's kind of like, first of all, no one has to see this but you. You do not have to share this. You do not have to talk to anyone else about this, right? This is just for you. And it's a snapshot. It's a moment in time. It's how you, where you are right now. Doesn't mean you're staying there. Doesn't mean you're happy with where that is. Could mean that you're very happy with where that is, right? But it's just to, again, kind of help you get this awareness of each area. So once you kind of rate where you are in each of those areas, circle those bottom one or two, right? The ones that are maybe the lowest. And then think about, how can you really focus there this month or for the next few months, right? Maybe you're like, I want to bump this up. Sometimes we're actually okay with where we are in some, even if maybe we're a 4 or a 5, we're like, you know, I'm okay with where I am in that right now, because I know things are kind of changing up. Things are happening maybe with relationships. I know we have folks who are going through separation, you know, having those kinds of things. And so sometimes where you are in that area right now is where you need to be. So it's not a bad thing. And so maybe you don't want to focus there. Maybe you want to focus on one of the areas you're high in to keep that high. And then kind of color in then where you're starting. And then you can revisit it at the end of the next few months and see maybe where some of those areas have changed, maybe where some of those have improved. It's great to have this as a check-in point. I know some folks who do it every month just so that they can kind of see where they are. So I'm going to show you lots of examples. And again, when I give you time to work on this, I'm going to just be cycling through these different examples. So you'll have some nice music and you'll be able to work on this. There's the nice one over on the left that's kind of just a little radiograph. And I think what they did there is they had like the blue was 1 month and the red was another month. So they could kind of see like beginning of the month, end of the month, kind of seeing how that worked, what that looked like. The person on the right really kind of writes a lot of different things in each of the area, kind of like different things that they're thinking of as they're thinking of rating education or thinking of things that they want to do more of financially. Fun ways to do it, right? You can do little stars, little squiggles, a little checkerboard for each one of those as you fill those in. And then again, the one on the right has some of the minimal coloring, gives a quick visual of where things are. And then they have those ideas up there for education. They want to do a Microsoft Suite class, spiritual, self-love, financial, save more, rebudget, right? So different ways that you can think of things that you can do in those areas. Again, using maybe balance as your grounding, writing about it, circling those bottom two, coloring in where you're starting. So again, here's some very colorful, very pretty ones. And again, you could start on it while we're here together and you can finish it up later, right? So some different kinds of things to think about in those areas. And here's some more. The one on the left is one of our other facilitators, Karen. If you ever have taken the Wheel of Life social with her, she talks a lot about how this activity early on really made her rethink her career and what she wanted to do. And she really kind of changed things up. She left one job, focused more on another, and she feels much more balanced, much more happiness. But you can see she did hers very quick, right? I mean, you can see they're just lines, numbers, doesn't have to be super fancy. I love the one in the middle. They made it into a little palm tree with where their little dots are. Again, another one on the right. And you can see too, kind of changing up some of the different ones. I think I might've passed some of the ones where they've changed the categories, but lots of different ways to do it. Coloring in bars, talking about different things that they want to do. Oops, that's the end of that one. So I think I was trying to find one where they had changed the category. I know there was one in here. Maybe. Oh yeah. So like in this one on the left, they changed adventure to hobbies, time to enjoy what I like. Right. So yeah, Natasha's saying, I find it helpful to not think too much before picking a number. Don't overthink this, right? First thing that pops into your mind, right? When you think about how am I with education? How do I feel with my education? Could be formal education, could be just informal learning, right? Like, how do you feel about where you are with learning right now? Financial, again, whatever pops into your head when you think of that, just pick a number 1 through 10 and pick that and pop that in, all right? So I'm going to be quiet. I'm going to play some music for you. Let us know in the chat if there's any of these areas that you are repurposing, maybe what you're changing. Maybe you're changing career to volunteer work. Maybe you're changing something to that crafting idea, right? Let us know kind of what is working for you, what kind of areas that you're looking at and how you're kind of, how you're approaching this, because that helps folks when they see how other people are doing this. And I'll cycle through some of these examples so you can see. So how are we doing? I saw some comments in the chat, some folks talking about finances maybe not being quite what they want them to be, kind of struggling with working with the budget. I am not, budgeting was never one of my strong suits. And we certainly never learned it in school, I don't think. What I've been trying to do this year is just really keeping track of every place I spend my money and then doing kind of like a little monthly review. So I use that, I think there's like the spending, don't we have like the little spending chart or something in there? I use that as kind of my monthly review, right? So how much did I earn this month? How much did I spend this month? The monthly expense tracker on page 25. So I kind of look at that and then I classify things as necessary purchases, maybe purchases, and unnecessary purchases. And so it's been really interesting this year to look each month and see how much we spend on dining out, how much we spend on entertainment, which isn't necessarily a bad thing, but it definitely, again, that awareness, right? Writing it down and seeing it is much easier for me to say, oh, maybe this month we're gonna only eat out once a week, right? And kind of see what that looks like, right? Again, some folks were kind of talking about health maybe not being as high as they wanted it to. I agree with that. I feel like I've kind of turned into more of a homebody. I used to go out and, run and bike and feel like I've been kind of staying in. So trying to get that movement back into my life. One of my sisters bought me a new fun wrist Fitbit. So I've been kind of wearing that, and it buzzes at me every hour if I don't have 250 steps. So that's kind of a fun little motivator. So I'm going to let you keep working for one more song, because I know sometimes this is a very meaty one to kind of dig into. And our next activity is going to be a little meaty as well. You've got a lot of intellectual things going on here on this Saturday morning. So I want to let you have some time to keep working on this page, right? So I'm going to, again, play another song and then check back in, and then we'll move on. So if you feel like you've already finished this and you're feeling good, if you want to move on to coloring, if you want to move on to your letter and kind of think about that, that's good as well. But I want to make sure you're able to kind of focus on those areas and what you want to do to maybe improve or keep them at a high level. Hey, hopefully that gave everyone enough time to get a good start there in their wheel of life, get a good grounding on what you want to work on to really kind of what these next 3 months are going to look like, right? And then that's the fun thing, is it'll be in another journal probably October, November, probably in December's or January's, But again, I like to kind of look at this every month and say, okay, is that still the same? Does that still hold true? Maybe what's changed? What do I need to look at? Sometimes my best intentions when I fill these out and then I forget because I don't look at them. So it's good to kind of keep an eye and look as you go through. So let's move on to our balance letter, right? Again, like I said, this is definitely, this is one of our more meatier socials, right? And Katie and I were talking about that. Some of our socials are maybe a little more lighthearted. And this one definitely is a little more intense, causes a little more inward focusing. So if anyone, you know, if you're kind of starting to feel maybe a little uncomfortable, or it's like, maybe it's a little too much for you right now, you know, take a break, listen to the music, do some coloring, do some, you know, check out one of the other activities in the journal. Certainly keep going if this is still feeling good for you. And thank you so much for sharing some of the different ways that you're working to improve different areas of your life, right? Kind of like thinking about finances, thinking about your home environment, how you're going to get that, you know, looking good or looking how you want, or being more closer to a 10, right, than some of those lower, the lower areas, right? So lots of good self-reflection here. As we move into our balance letter on page 16, sometimes I feel really inspired to write this letter style, but then sometimes I feel more of a bullet pointy kind of gal. So I'll show you mine here in a second. But what you're going to do is you're going to write a letter to yourself and really think about what in your life needs to remain, what needs to kind of keep going, and then what needs to maybe change in order for you to feel more balanced, centered, and inspired. I love that. Balanced, centered, and inspired, right? Three great ways to feel. I think we would all say, yes, I want to feel balanced. Yes, I want to feel centered. Yes, I want to feel inspired. And then what changes can you make each day? Maybe little changes, maybe little tweaks, little things you can do, little things you can stop doing. So you're going to kind of write this letter to yourself. So like I said, I kind of started out with kind of doing like, let's think about balance in our life, what needs to stay, what needs to go or change so we can feel more balanced, centered, and inspired. And then I didn't necessarily feel inspired to write it letter style. So I kind of started this remain column and then a change column. So I want to remain a lifelong learner. I love learning things. I have my PhD, so I have plenty of college formal stuff, but I like learning the informal things, which is one of the reasons I love Silk and Sonder so much and being able to interact with you, because I learned so much from all of our Sonder fam. But I need to change my feeling that I need to cram in knowledge, that I need to constantly be reading and reading more and reading faster and doing more and taking online classes and signing up for online webinars, right? Sometimes that gets a little too much and I don't feel that balance and center and inspired. I feel just overwhelmed. So kind of finding that balance there. I definitely want to keep with the financial responsibility, but I also need to change up my workaholic tendencies where I'm constantly working and feeling like I need to constantly be finding new things to bring in money so that I can always have money. Keep my love of knitting and crafting, but change my sable ways. So if you're a crafter, you might know what sable stands for. It stands for stash acquired beyond life expectancy, which basically means I have enough yarn, even if I knit every day, all day long, for the rest of my life, more than likely I won't get through it all. So finding ways to change. I have a yarn room, I will admit it. I will not show you a picture of it, but I will admit it. So kind of trying to change that. I don't need to buy any more yarn, and maybe there's some I need to kind of pass on to someone else, right? So yeah, Natasha's saying we have the same problem in cross stitch world. Yeah, so that's the other problem. Like I've started doing some painting and I'm catching myself like buying all this paint and buying all these supplies, and crafting tends to be like that. I mean, I guess there's worse things I could buy, but yes, Michelle, yeah, sable. So scrapbooking stuff, knitting, crochet, cross stitch. I've actually got my husband doing embroidery now. So he's starting to acquire things, which is kind of fun. Staying in touch with my family and friends, but I really want to limit my social media and do more of the face-to-face piece, right? I want to start up my training again because I want to do another half marathon, but I don't want to overdo it. Sometimes I tend to get a little, I kind of get that all or nothing thinking, right? Stop my all or nothing thinking and do what's maybe better for me physically. Cultivate some focus at work. So I need to kind of change some of that up a little bit. And then I want to seek new experiences, but I want to collect experiences, not stuff. So that's kind of the, that's the idea, right? So here's, you can make a T-chart. You can write a letter from your younger self to now. You can write it as a letter to your younger self. You can write it as a letter to you from your pet. Maybe your pet has some special insights into what you need to change up and what you need to keep. Remember to reflect on both positive things and that you want to retain and the negative things that you want to change. Okay. So spend some time working on this in whatever way feels good for you. I see lots of people sharing in the chat that SABLE is kind of their new favorite acronym, and it works for everything, right? Because it's acquired, anything stash that's acquired beyond life expectancy, right? So again, play a song, and then I'll check back in and see how everyone's doing. Thank you. Well, thank you all so much for sharing some of the different things that you're putting in your balance letter. I love, you know, some of you wrote lovely long prose letters to yourself. Others did kind of the, you know, that T-chart idea. There was the one that I thought was great. And now I'm like trying to scroll back here quickly through the chat where it was the different categories. So instead of maybe saying, keep this and stop this kind of thing, it was the, I get to try, right? Trisha had, I get to try. So keep on keeping on and I get to try as those columns. And I love that, right? Find those fun headers to kind of keep, you know, to keep you motivated. So thank you so much for spending Saturday morning with us in these very deep, these were deep exercises, right? Each one of them really kind of had you do a lot of self-reflection, and that can be a little tiring sometimes. So if you need to take a little nap after this, you have my permission. I'll write you a note if anyone needs that. Or maybe you feel really invigorated and really energized and you want to go out and kind of burn that off. And so you're going to go for a nice walk or you're going to go for a swim, bike ride, something fun outside. So please take the time to do that. So here's a couple. There's the QR code to take the survey and you get that in your email. Yeah, Crystal says I'm exhausted and need a nap. Yes. And I'll post the playlist here in just a sec. So can make sure that you have the app, Sonder Club app, because I love, we love seeing your examples. All those examples were people who had posted things on Sonder Club. So we love to share that because everyone gets great ideas. Also, you can do the 10 for 10, the refer a friend. So if you scan that, you get $10. And if your friend signs up, they get the $10. Also to use on Sonder stuff, Sonder swag. And then the ever important YouTube link for the social recordings. Remember, you have to have that link. You can't find it by searching YouTube. You can't just go to Silk and Sonder's page. You have to actually keep a hold of that link. And I think someone mentioned in the chat that hopefully Android users can actually click on the links in the app now because we weren't able to before. So I'm hoping that that works because there's always, this is a long link to try to type in you know, when you're trying to find things. So you can always email hello@silkandsonder.com if you need a link, if you need some help with anything, and they can always help you as well. So here is the playlist from today. So you can kind of take a snap of those, the different songs that I used. Hopefully those worked well. And my favorite, that's my favorite new dance around song is The Clarity by Vance Joy. And I would encourage you to play the song and sing it to yourself as you look in the mirror, because it has the, it was you, right? So think about how you're treating yourself and how you're going forward. You did a lot of really deep thinking. Take some time to reflect on that. Take a nap, take a walk, play a song, dance around. I think we're going to go out and do a little hike in the mountains. We'll see how that goes. Haven't been up hiking in the mountains probably since before COVID. So we'll see how that is. And hopefully I will see you again soon. I don't think I have another social 10 Lux Friday night. So I have a little bit of a break, but hopefully you will come to our setups. We've got monthly setups. We've got weekly setups. We have lots of fun socials coming up in October. So love, love, love spending time with you here on this Saturday morning. And hopefully you have a fantastic weekend. Thank you all so much for being here. Sometimes
healing, won't you please give me a